outside. And the most important part of the game, summary, coming up in a minute, after we see points in the paint, with the Lakers dominating 64-40, is the fact that the banner went up tonight. And there it is in the spotlight, as it should be, Stu Lance.
Banner number 17.
Another on the wall.
What it's all about is what you play the game for. See if you can hoist one of those.
And no matter where they land, be it the play-in or the sixth spot, he said it's going to be difficult to get into that automatic spot. Looks like they might be headed for the play-in, but again, they're confident no matter where they land.
Well, you know, we've documented, obviously, again tonight, the absence of LeBron and Anthony Davis, but we haven't really talked about Dennis Schroeder that much. They miss Dennis Schroeder a lot. They really do.
And Dennis Schroeder, what is it, seven games in a row for Schroeder? Seventh one out, COVID protocol for the second time this year. He missed four earlier. And they are hoping that he will play this weekend. I think has been determined. Just like the times of the game. Here is Thomas. Turn, shoot, score.
Like I said, they're scoring at will.
Cameron Oliver went to Nevada for a couple of years. Again, made his NBA debut Monday. He was playing in Australia this year, Stu. He came that far, and now he's playing this well.
He's showing that you persevere. You just keep doing what you like to do.
Ort Tucker, man, goes down. Good give. Ort Tucker with yet another assist. McKinney to finish seven assists. Seventh dime for THT.
Yeah, once Thomas went down to the floor, they were a man short of easy score.
Houston's been shooting the ball very well in the quarter, but now they turn it over. And the Lakers with an opportunity. Just go ahead and grab THT.
Thomas again versus THT. He just fouled again. But that last play, see him read the screen and goes the opposite way and makes an easy pass to McKinney for the flush. THT back to the free throw line now. He's been there only one other time to shoot two, and he made both of those.
Only two turnovers for Taylor Horton Tucker after seven the other night. It was an interesting exchange late in overtime. He had turned it over two times in a row, and Derrick Rose had stripped it away from him on the second turnover. Then he turned right around, and as his coach said, he had a lot of guts to shoot that one. And he didn't hesitate. And now he's going to try to get the rebound. Oh, and the Lakers do get it with McKinney.
That's a good job by THT to keep it alive.
Yeah, excellent fighting. Scrapping, clawing in there. Lob underneath, and Montrez can't finish it. It just rolled off the rim for Montrez Harrell, the reigning sixth man of the year in the NBA. Oliver. Now to the right side, and it's Brooks. Right back to Oliver. They're playing a two-man game with a minute 20 remaining. This is long distance.
Well, I tell you, Brooks is feeling it.
Did I tell you, three-point specialist?
He's got 21 in 23 minutes.
I mean, 84% of his shots have been from out there. McLemore, also a specialist from downtown. Hit Mac for three.
Another assist for THT, his eighth.
He's racking him up. Underneath Montrez, decent defense, going to get a foul. Might be on the rebound.
Yeah, it is a push on Coons, too. This long triple by Brooks as he steps back and drains it. But Ben McLemore drifts into the corner and spots up, knocks it down.
Houston with the second lowest three-point percentage for the Lakers. They're in the bottom 10 as far as three-point percentage shooting. Houston 27th in offense, 27th in defense. Kind of what you would expect for a team that has the worst record in the league. They will host the Clippers Friday and then end the season Sunday at Atlanta. Atlanta still has something to play for, so
well,
the Clippers.
Yeah, they clean Atlanta, clinch the playoff spot today.
Do they clinch their actual spot? Or just to
clinch the playoffs.
Yeah.
Being in the playoffs.
Yeah, in the playoffs, yeah. Where they will end up, though, is still to be determined. Let's come back here for them, too. Hopefully, he's locked up with Denver. see who's going to finish in the 3 and 4 spot. And it looks like that Denver's going to probably be the fourth. Here's Horton Tucker!
Just filling with confidence seemingly every game.
I said that about Denver, but it was Utah who lost tonight. Lakers steal it away. You've got 22 seconds remaining in the quarter. Look at the pass to McKinney. Horton Tucker, the vision last night and tonight.
Well, he's got 9 assists now. His career high is only 11. And with 12 minutes to play, good chance.
Shot clock is off for the quarter. Ooh, McKinney made a mistake, and it's going to cost him 3 free throws. Boy, they threw Chubb in the water, and he was all over it.
Yeah, but THG's made back-to-back plays. The first one was a step-back jumper, and then the pass that he threw to McKinney, and McKinney with the left-hand layup to give THG his 9th assist of the ball game.
So it is a 7-point lead
for
the time being. That's DJ at the line. Daryl Gerard Augustine Jr. And there's Talen Horton Tucker. Second round pick for the Lakers. Augustine's first point tonight. Scratching for the first time. He's a great free throw shooter. Below 91%. Oldest player on the team. There he is. Half basketball will travel. 10th team.
Let's see what the Lakers do with 3.4. They made a substitution there, bringing Markieff back. Maybe because he's the guy they went for in the long pass.
Let's see what this is all about. He's making sure they know what he wants them to do, and it is Markieff that will try to throw the quarterback long pass. Here it goes. Guns it, looking for Kuzma. Horton Tucker, he's going to know. I thought he was going to score.
He should have.
How lucky could they be? Unfortunately, they couldn't finish it.
Easiest shot that THT has had tonight, and he comes up dry. We'll head to the fourth with the Underman Rockets hanging close. They only trail the Lakers by 4, 100-96.